There you go, Cyndi Lauper. Girls just want to have fun here at Classic Hits. Waking up happy with PJ and Jim. Thank you for doing that. What are we, 9 minutes past 8 o'clock? We promised you stars. We've got them. Look at this. Old friend of the show, Ryan Andrews. Yay! Welcome along. Yay. And his beautiful dance partner, Giulia, is with us as well. Giulia Dotton, good to have you in, folks.
Thanks so much.
Thanks for having us.
Superstars.
Yeah, so we've just been going through your routine. Basically, Navy SEALs have nothing on you guys at the moment.
Having the patch, PJ. Yeah. The hours that we're doing. Yeah, it's mad, isn't it?
Yeah, so just because you were running us through it there, but you're in Dancing with the Stars. You're flying, right? In fairness, you're almost as good as a priest.
Getting there.
But you're flying. But I don't think people understand how tough this show is on the contestants of it.
I didn't even realise kind of getting into it. But like, so say a day like today, you're up in the morning, you're doing obviously media then as well. Then we will start rehearsing at 11 till about 7 o'clock tonight. Mm-hmm. And it's all day, kind of
but
every day.
I tell you what's weird for us, right? Hearing you say that it's tough, because you're Mr. Showbiz. I mean, we've seen you work
on
the panto and stuff.
I'll take that, Mr. Showbiz.
But you know what I mean?
Like, the panto stuff was ridiculous, the amount of work that went in. Yeah. You're saying this is even tougher again.
Oh, this is way tougher.
And it's mad because it's only like a minute and 30 of choreography, but like the amount of technical elements and like just everything that you need to work on it, it's
hard. And it's mentally draining. So like, you might go from a high of a Sunday night and get a 10 and everybody's standing up. Then on the Monday morning,
you've got to come in and talk to agents like us.
Like PJ and Jim, this is the hard part.
Drag you right down to reality.
So that's what it is. There's just so much involved. The VT, the behind the scenes. And as I said, it's only a minute and 30, what Giulia said.
Yes.
But the pressure of when they say, dancing, the cha-cha, Ryan Andrews. And then
it's like, what leg do I start with?
What leg do I start off? And then you start forgetting everything. So
Giulia, right, give us an inside thing on Ryan then, right? Literally, when you got him in his raw state for the first time.
Yeah.
Right, because I mean, we would assume that he's, like I said, the whole Mr. Showbiz thing, I mean, he's been at it since he's about 10 in terms of acting and the whole sort of all of that sort of stagecraft.
Yes.
So did you think, I can do something with this lad? Or did you think, oh my God!
Oh, no. I thought, like, he had potential, but it's funny how people think that he had some sort of dancing background and then makes it easier. If anything, it makes it harder because people are going to expect him to be amazing.
Right.
He's amazing.
Be careful now, Giulia.
He eventually gets there on the Sunday, but it's a long process to get there. So it's a lot of work that he's putting in. It's not just, it doesn't happen like this.
And are you planning dances then in advance all the time? You have to be like sort of 1 week ahead of the two of you constantly.
Weeks. Yeah, 2 weeks ahead. Yeah. So it's
the work that the pros do, it's incredible. They're, like I said, 2 weeks ahead, but it's choreography for two dances in the time. They have to do director tapes.
Yeah.
It's like, it is crazy.
We don't even know if we get there eventually.
Oh, of course not.
Which is a shame because sometimes you're looking forward to do some sort of dances and then you don't even get there. But it's part of the game.
I think it's fair to say you're kind of going to be there for another few weeks. Yes. I think that's it.
Like, hopefully, like, having the time of my life, like, it's one of the hardest things, but it's the best thing that I've, like, genuinely ever done. Like even think about it now.
Is it a little bit frustrating, right? That you can sort of like put the work in and let's just say, let's call a spade a spade. Actually be good.
Yeah.
And let's just say that somebody who's maybe not so good, but maybe might just be a bit sort of popular or funny or something, would get a load of votes. Yeah. Can that be just a little bit sort of
frustrating?
But that's kind of part. Like, if you got it, PJ, you'd be straight to the final. You'd win it straight away.
Oh, well, I mean, he might last till the final.
I don't think we'll last.
Sign him up, lads. But that's, like, going into it, like, at the end of the day, like, it's a show.
It's an entertainment show. You know, people like someone that is not as good, but they think it's funny or whatever, then
that's part of it. Like, and that's what, like, so all we want to do is just go out and literally do the best we can do, because not every dance suits you as well.
Of course. Mm-hmm.
So like, some dances, like last week we had the salsa that was fun. We dressed up as geeks. Like, it got a great, it was really just great fun, where the week before was a waltz, which is
very stiff.
Right. And slow. So I wasn't restricted.
Which you hate. It's just like, oh my God, another ballroom dance.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hate being
Yeah, whereas
held back.
Whereas like other people that go, thank God I don't have to think too much about this one. Yeah. Like,
well,
this,
there you go.
Remember the moves.
Yes, I'm literally going to cling on for dear life.
Yeah,
and let her drag me around.
Giulia, take control.
Yeah. Well, I do say that as well. And but Giulia has a little tip as well. Like you can't see. You probably shouldn't be saying this, but when Giulia is there, she goes 5, 6, 7, 8. Move to your right, so she does it through.
I'm becoming like a triloquist.
Just as a matter of interest, right? Is there a move? Because you know, PJ, we were talking earlier on the show. You may not have been aware of it, but we were talking about PJ and his need for exercise. Like, because
I exercise all the time. Yeah. It's outrageous now.
You look great, PJ. Yeah. Great.
Well, thanks for you. I don't need your lies either.
looks can be deceived, you know. Anyway, so listen, is there a move? Like, what would be the classic sort of introductory move from a dance perspective, right?
Okay.
If you had a sort of a total novice, right, what would be the move that you'd kind of sample out whether or not they had anything about them?
I'd say maybe just feel kind of like the music and the rhythm, so then maybe just like each literally just walking on the spot. That'd be like the first
thing. Do you think you could manage to walk on the spot, PJ?
Walk on the spot?
Yeah, with a bit of hip movement.
Look at that.
Look at
that.
A bit of hip movement
going
on there.
Showing off.
Let's go, PJ.
Oh, this is embarrassing.
Right.
Not only can I walk on the spot, Jim, I can walk dogs.
You look like you're on the cross trainer.
Yeah.
The hips are going 90.
But listen, actually, Joe, something on a serious note for a second, right? We've been slagging with PJ all morning about the fact that he may not make it to the end of the show. But seriously, this thing for you, dancing in this, right, is kind of a big deal. And there is a sort of a medical connection to it, isn't it? Because you had the diagnosis of, it's a scoliosis.
Yeah, so scoliosis and Shearman's kyphosis. Now, for people out there, scoliosis, people would know, is like the curvature of the spine. And Shearman's kyphosis is the roundature of the shoulder. So, like, I have both of them. I was diagnosed when I was 14 years of age. And it was a Crumlin hospital, and I went in and, you know, because the teachers, like, the school teachers said they could see I was starting to get increasingly hunched over.
Right, yeah.
And he said, all of a sudden, it was just like that, because I was very small as a child. And I just took a stretch.
Yes.
And yes, so they went in and got the x-rays. And yes, so I've...
And how do you rectify that? Is that a surgical thing, or is it just over a period of time?
I'm very, very lucky that no surgery was needed.
Right.
And needed, because look, I know I've actually friends for over the years who need surgery, and it's one of the worst, most horrific surgeries.
Yeah,
not to get
yeah.
serious about it,
no,
but like
no,
it's really,
yeah, but, no,
really...
But it is
a spinal thing. Like, yeah.
Yeah, so even now, I'm standing up, but beforehand, that's my nap. You know, it's like, so it's just, so with the show as well, I never thought I'd get the opportunity to do it. And Giulia choreographed an amazing piece. We did a rumba to Fix You. It was a slow Coldplay song. And that was kind of like that was my moment on the show that I'll always remember. And if I had left that night, I would have been very happy.
Right,
because that was a personal kind of.
Big one for you.
A big one for me. And even thinking about it now, I'm relaxed about it. I'm like, that was good. So as you said, it was a thing of like, I was told I couldn't do it. I was told I shouldn't do it when I was 16. A teacher said, don't be like Ryan. Don't look like him. Don't stand like him. So, for me to go and...
So now you're doing this going, so you can stick that in your ear.
Well, it's a huge, personal thing in this as well.
It was a personal thing. That's all it was. And it was nothing about the show. As Giulia said, it wasn't about the scores. It was for me to do something for myself.
Brilliant, Personal victory
Tell us about this weekend then, very quickly. Tell us what's on the agenda, what's on the menu for this weekend.
Giulia knows.
What do we allowed now, yeah.
So it's orchestra week this week.
Okay.
Which is the, I think, is probably the one that everyone is most looking forward to it, because we have a full-on orchestra behind us, and they are incredible. And we can't really say much about it then. So
really?
That's it. See you later, lads.
Right, so on that basis, if you want to vote for Ryan.
But that's what it is. Like, the massive... We went actually into RT last week to hear the orchestra playing. It's...
And he was pitchless, which is...
That takes a bit. He's been on the show a few times.
Stopping
him talking.
Had to tap his eyes. I was like, are you feeling okay?
It was when the oboes were playing, I was like, oh, that was unbelievable.
Oh, nothing gets me more than an oboe.
I've seen you
mad for the oboes in here.
I've seen you well up over an oboe in the past, PJ. I really have.